In this video, I will explain how SAP system communicates with its database. The SAP system which will be installed on top of database, that is RDBMS. Let us go through these paragraphs for better understanding. Database interface of AS ABAP. Relational database management system are generally used to manage large sets of data. An RDBMS saves data and relationships between data in the form of two-dimensional tables. These are known for their logical simplicity. Data tables and table relationships are defined at database level in the database catalog of the RDBMS. Within the SAP programming language ABAP, you can use ABAP OpenSQL to access the application data in the database regardless of the RDBMS used. Whatever the database type may be, it may be Oracle, it may be MaxDB, it may be MS SQL Server, or it may be DB2. Whatever the database is, the ABAP program, that is ABAP OpenSQL, to access the application data in the database regardless of RDBMS used. The database interface, which is part of every work process of AS ABAP, each and every work process will have database interface, translates OpenSQL statements from ABAP into the corresponding SQL statements for the specific database used, and it will be converted, the SQL statement will be converted into native SQL, and it will communicate with the database. This allows ABAP programs to be database independent. So this type of scenario is enables ABAP programs to be database independent. That may be, it can be installed on any type of database. ABAP OpenSQL is a database query language based on the SQL standard that also contains enhancements that are not included in the standard. When interpreting OpenSQL statements, the SAP database interface checks the syntax of these statements and ensures the optimal utilization of the local SAP buffers in the shared memory of the application server. When interpreting OpenSQL statement, when you are using this OpenSQL statement, the SAP database interface checks the syntax of these statements and ensures the optimal utilization, best utilization of the local SAP buffers in the shared memory of the application server. Data that is frequently required by the applications is stored in these buffers so that the system does not have to access the database server to read this data. In particular, all technical data such as ABAP programs, screens, and ABAP dictionary information, as well as a number of business administration parameters, usually remain unchanged in an operational system and are therefore ideally suited to buffering. Whatever the frequently used data will be stored in the database buffer within the application server shared memory, that is in the RAM, that is main memory, so that quickly data can be accessed from the buffers without contacting actual database. So let us look at this graphic so that you will clearly understand about the concept. You see this graphic here, you have a ABAP interpreter within the work process, and the ABAP program is written like this: select star from so and so table, and this particular statement is OpenSQL statement. So that OpenSQL statement is directly going to database interface of the work process. Database interface, what it will do, it will contact local buffer. If the data is stored in this, the data is available in the local buffer, that will be given to the database interface immediately without going to database level. So the data will be transferred to the ABAP interpreter so that the data will be displayed to the user using a screen. Okay, and if that particular data is not available in the local buffer, so that the data, whatever the open SQL statement, that will be converted into native SQL statement, and it will contact the actual original database which is installed for this particular system. Okay, then the data will be fetched from the database and that will be handover to the database interface again. Here you see, so from here it will be fetched and that will be converted into the data, and it will gives to the ABAP interpreter and it will process it and it will show to the user. So not only ABAP statements, that is open SQL statement, you can also write native SQL statements directly using this exec SQL and exec bracket. So when you use this particular bracket, you can directly call the database without depending on this DB interface. And if you write these statements, there is no database independence. Whatever the database you are using, for that database you are writing statements. So you cannot use this for database independence. Furthermore, native SQL commands can be used directly in ABAP, that is without using the local buffers and without the database interface interpreting the commands. You can do this by including the commands in an exec SQL and exec bracket in the ABAP program, like this here. The ABAP interpreter does not check the syntax of any commands within this bracket. ABAP interpreter will not check the syntax of any commands within this bracket. If you use native SQL, you can no longer ensure the platform independence of the affected programs. We should not expect this platform independence because we are directly writing the SQL commands for that particular database. Okay, so that's all about connecting to the database in the SAP systems. In this way, the SAP system will operate to connect to the database. So using the database interface which is available in the work process, each work process will have this DB interface, ABAP interpreter, and shared memory will have this local buffer, and entire functionality will be done within the SAP system. I hope you understood how SAP system will access database. Thanks for watching.